afternoon.
How are you? You are in Geneva in your headquarters right now. Where are you sitting?
Yes, indeed. We are at the MSC Cruises headquarters here in Geneva. And good afternoon, everybody. And it's a pleasure and honor to be here today at ITB.
Great to have you with us at ITB Now. Thank you, Pierfrancesco. You are one of the few cruise lines that resumed cruising already with one of your biggest ships. So we are not talking about small ships here. We're talking about big ships with reduced guest capacity, with very stringent hygiene and the safety protocols. What message would you have in terms of best practice? What could the tourism industry, but probably also other industries, learn from your experience in having carried thousands of people safely so far?
Well, Thomas, it's this is an experience that has been acquired in the last year. So 12 months went by. And obviously, let's not forget that we had a lot of learning time, and you know, we've been through a lot of emergencies. You know, we started last year with the world shutting down, and we had the ships operating all over the world, and we learned a lot by actually securing and repatriating the passengers and the crew members while airports and countries and borders were shutting down, and where a lot of the health authorities didn't have any idea of what was actually taking place. So we did a lot of learning, we did a lot of lesson learned, and then we put our head together. We have the capability to react, we have incredible pieces of machinery, we have the technology, we have the capacity to react. We already had the other type of viruses in the past, for which on the health, on the safety, on the security side, we did a lot of lesson learning. And we put our heads together and we started to engage with the authorities. So we went to the Healthy Gateway, which is the university that puts together all, let's say, the performance for all the different industry at European level, how to come in with protocol, how to restart during the pandemic.
I mean, if I may just interrupt you, the challenge is that you are incredibly global, right?
Yes, obviously. Yes, yes. So you need to have a vision. You need to be local. You need to be global, but understand what's happening locally. So we sat down together with these authorities and we put together a protocol. A protocol, obviously, in a previous mode. So in emergency mode, when obviously there was no vaccine and we were all learning about testing. So we actually implemented the protocol, a very stringent protocol that took care of the testing and creating the ship as a bubble. So technology for the air conditioning, to the sanitation of the areas, keeping the distance, proving the short contact, you know, again with technology, having bracelet, passenger could wear bracelets, and actually we could see scientifically if a person came in close contact with another person more than so many minutes. So technology together with the protocol, together with a lot of systems in place and testing, we started and we proved that we could create such a bubble so that passenger, tourist, cruisers could actually go and sit in the ship and looking at the sea, looking at the sunset and be in a safety mode. And this was very successful because we had during the various curfews around Europe, and obviously the ship is operating in the Med, we had a situation where at 6 o'clock restaurants and bars were shutting down, and the only place where you could have a sushi and a beer at 11 o'clock at night mingling with other people was actually a cruise ship. And so far, all this has proven, you know, we carried the cruise industry in the last few months have carried successfully with such a protocol, with the standard being set up by the CLIA. We carried in excess of 350,000 passengers.
So 350,000 passengers, and you had some COVID cases, but you detected them, right? You did detect them, you could isolate passengers. So that proved, as far as I see, I don't know what your opinion is in this, but that proved that the system is really safety proof. Would you say that the industry and other industries that yes, cruising is safer maybe than many other ways of traveling or many other areas in tourism? Would you go that far?
Thomas, yes, for a simple reason that in our protocol, testing was key. So we tested, we screened all our crew members, we put them in quarantine. So we tested before they left their countries, we gave them dedicated transport, we tested upon arrival, we put them in isolation for 14 days, we tested them again. So we create a bubble ship with our staff, with our seafarers working on the ship. And we did the same approach with the passenger. So not only according to the area where the passenger would originate, we would ask them to do a PCR, a molecular test, you know, due to the prevalence of a particular area. But upon embarkation, we did a second test, you know, to ensure that we screened all the people that would actually enter this environment being the ship. And this is the key to the protocol. This was the key to the success, because in some cases, according to the curve of the pandemic, we increased the testing with, again, a rapid testing on board. So clients, customers were used to be tested because the world had moved, had changed. And
that's the new normal. It's the new normal, right?
The new normal of testing.
Yeah. Exactly. Sounds very impressive, sounds interesting indeed. What do you think, will Corona be a kind of, because what we hear a lot when we're talking about cruising is the word sustainability, right? And do you think that COVID-19 might be also a sustainability booster, or has to be a sustainability booster for the cruise industry as well?
Well, Thomas, first of all, let me say, so we had the first phase of the emergency, then we had the new normal, which was the testing. Now we live in a third phase, which is the vaccine rollout, which is again another game changer. And obviously there will be still some testing, but we see that in some parts of the world, you know, herd immunity is on the reach. Today we heard that UK, England, on the May 17th, will actually reopen to hospitality and cruising because they will reach that herd immunity. We'd heard President Biden saying that by May, United States will reach herd immunity. The problem is that, unfortunately, the job in Europe wasn't handled as clearly and as efficiently like these other parts of the world. Unfortunately, there is no a vaccine that has been developed in Europe. So Europe is lacking the capability, the control, the knowledge to have an IP European vaccine. And this is a great pity. So we will actually leave a phase until the vaccine will be delivered. Testing will be important for all type of hospitality, especially for cruising, as vaccine will be available, as we will reach a level in society where more vaccinated people will come. And obviously this will enter into a new phase, which is documentation, which is the capability to see who's been vaccinated, who had the COVID, and how to open the frontiers and harmonize, and hopefully, you know, between all the health authorities in Europe for traveling, you know, to have an harmonization and somehow an orchestration of how all this should be operated. Because obviously travel industry requires an harmonization and one control cabin that can ensure, you know, a smooth operation.
But so sustainability, I think, as I understand, and I've seen your press releases and observing also your development of MSC Cruises, I think you put a lot of focus, already before you did put a lot of focus to sustainability even more. But do you think that COVID is something which is boosting the need for the tourism industry, and especially also for the cruise industry, to boost, to focus much more on sustainability?
Well, Europe has a very important green agenda. I think we all came to the realization how important it is to live in a world that is decarbonized. And many industries are working in that direction. Cruise industry is not forgetting that that is our commitment. At MSC, we know that even if we're acting with the emergency, with the pandemic, we have the green agenda, we have the decarbonization, we have sustainability always as a priority in what it is that we need to do. I think this has been psychologically, this COVID, this pandemic had an impact on the psychology of many citizens, many tourists. People can't wait to go out there. We all need to see the sun. We all need to see a sunset and see the sea. Cruise will be a perfect scene to do so because it will be in a safe bubble. But we all came to at the same time to the realization that a green world is a better world. So if we can give the capability of traveling and if we can give the capability by with a decarbonization agenda, that will be the win-win situation that not only us as hospitality industry, but the world needs. So a much greener world. And okay, that is always there in our agenda.
Thank you. I have one last question. We have only about 1.5 minutes left. So short answer is possible. Maybe a difficult question, maybe a very simple question to you. Let's see. If you swapped your CEO hat, your executive hat for policymaker's hat for one day, what measure would you put in place for the travel and tourism industry?
Well, like I said before, if I had to have a political hat, I would ensure that we would have a vaccine and we would have the right quantities and the supply chain insured. And second of all, I would start then looking at these documents that will allow an harmonization of how travelers, as you know, countries will reach in different modes, in different periods, herd immunity levels. And so that will be a priority to how to ensure, you know, the recognition of the vaccine, because obviously we have vaccines that are recognized by the FDA in North America, vaccines that are recognized in Europe, vaccines that are not recognized and that are manufactured in different parts of the world. So that will be a further complexity. If you have a Chinese or a nation that has not been recognized in Europe, how will you allow that person to enter Europe? So as a politician, I would ensure there will be an alignment in how we think to have this green passport for traveling in order to allow freedom of movement of people once more.
Thank you very much. That's very impressive, very interesting. And time is already over. We could talk for another 2 hours at least, but let's do that next time. I thank you very much, Pier Francesco Vago. Great having you with us at IDB Now, and I hand back to Roland. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Thomas. Thank you.